estimation of approximate monthly energy bill in terms of the kilowatt hour over here. So basically in earlier session we have talked what are the various home appliances that generally use in the residential sector, what is the watt capacity of the corresponding instruments are there actually. In this session we're going to be talk how we can calculate the approximate monthly electricity bills in terms of the kilowatt hour over here actually. How we can just do this procedure for calculations of the electricity bill by just overweighing the number of appliances has been used in the corresponding home sectors over here actually. So for that purpose we're going to see this Excel sheet. So basically we can prepare the Excel sheet for preparation of monthly electricity bill calculation over here. So basically in the first part over here we're going to talk about the class of appliances. So what are the general class appliances, that cooling appliances, heating appliances and other appliances, what we have seen actually. So that we have to just write over here. Next is what are the various appliances that generally used by the residential scale. So that we have to be see over here actually. So in that case is whatever in earlier session we have talked, lamp, tube light, refrigerator, everything we have been considered, which quite used by the residential sectors over here. Third column we have to prepare is the power consumption in terms of the watt over here actually. Power consumption in terms of the watt is showing that which instrument is using how much amount of the wattage capacity. So simultaneously we get an idea how much kind of a VA capacity of inverter or UPS we require to be select for the fulfill the need of the corresponding equipments over here actually. So this also we know basically in the Excel sheet we have seen over here actually. Now the fourth column we're going to see is the quantity of the equipments. This also matters over here. If we have a three numbers of the refrigerator, if we have a three numbers of the fan, so simultaneous watt consumption will be vary over here actually. So in this case we're going to be talk or we're going to be see as an one equipments over here actually. Later we can just vary for just changing the electricity bill requirements over here actually. The fifth column is the number of hours of the operations over here actually. So basically numbers of hours of the operation, how many hours the corresponding equipment is running, it decides what is the watt hour range of this corresponding equipment is. And this particular parameter we needed when we decides what amount of the ampere hour capacity we want to attach to the given solar home system. So we have to just write it over here how much time this per corresponding equipment is running actually in the systems over here. Sixth column we're going to be talk is the watt hour per daily over here actually. It means what? How much amount of the watt hour for the corresponding equipment it is consuming on the daily capacity. For the calculation of the watt hour actually, we require this kinds of the calculation. So first we required over here actually, whenever we just do the calculation of the watt hour capacity in the daily format. So first we required how much amount of the power is consumed by the appliances. So let's say the lamp, if we are taking the lamp is required the 100 watt for the consumptions over here. So we just select this particular cell, multiply by how many quantities of a lamp we are using for the system. So that quantity we have to select by this corresponding cell and multiply by how much hour this corresponding lamp is working actually. So that also we have to select over here, bracket complete and enter. So this shows actually what is a watt hour consumption for the lamp actually whenever one quantity of a lamp is running for the 1 hour of the duration. So if we change the hour of a duration as in 3, so simultaneous the watt hour range will change up to 300 watt hour over here actually. If we change the quantity as in 5 over here, it will shows the watt hour ranges will be the 1500 watt hour per daily capacity over here. So like that actually, as per the change of the requirement, we can just calculate with the help of this Excel sheet simply by applying this formula. Now we're going to see the last column, which is the kilowatt hour per monthly basis. It means what? Whatever the lamp we are considered as an first appliances in a system. So basically lamp is consuming the 100 watt and the total number of a quantity is 1. The number of working hours are 1. So the lamp per daily basis, it is required the watt hour of 100 watt hour per daily basis over here. So if I want to convert this corresponding watt hour daily basis into the number of units in the monthly basis, because unit has been measured in terms of the kilowatt hour. So that is why we have to do some calculation so that we can calculate per monthly basis how much lamp will going to contribute in the kilowatt hour consumption over here. So for that purpose, we just write a formula equal to, in a bracket, we just select the watt hour plus daily capacity of this corresponding lamp divided by 1000, because we are converting the watt hour into the kilowatt hour systems over here, multiplied by 30. So 30 means we are multiplying as on daily basis, it's consuming the 100 watt hour daily. So multiply by 30 monthly basis, how much amount of the unit has been generated. So that we have to be calculated over here. So we just write the formula over here and enter. So it shows that whenever a lamp is running for 1 hour daily basis, it is consuming the 3 kilowatt hour of the unit on the monthly basis. If we are changing the working hour as in 5 over here, so it will show daily basis it is required 500 watt hour daily, and monthly basis it will going to generate, or it will going to consume the 15 numbers of the unit monthly basis over here. So simultaneously, once we have taken these values over here, actually simply just pull this particular cell, so the formula will be applied for overall cells over here. Actually similarly, just pull this cell also like that. So whenever we want to generate the electricity bill, so we have to make an audit for the solar home systems in the designing purpose over here. Actually we just see how much numbers of the equipments has been available in the corresponding residential sector. Only that equipment we are considering in the calculations over here. We ask to the corresponding consumer how much amount of the hour this equipment is running in the system as per their requirement. So that we have to put it over here. Number of quantities as per the audit, we can just keep it over here. And from that, we can just approximately estimate how much amount of the kilowatt hour will require for the consumer at the end of the month for the fulfilling their needs of the capacity over here. So like that, for every equipment, we just do the same calculation by changing the number of hours, changing the number of quantities. So automatically we'll get this value by applying this formula simply over here actually. So it is the easiest method that we can apply for calculation of the approximate monthly energy bill in the solar home systems over here.